Have you visited your new teacher library yet? In this video, we'll show you how to create custom book collections to share with your students from your teacher library. If you've already been to the teacher library, keep watching because we've added some new functionality to make it even better. All right, let's start by going to your teacher library and select the dropdown. Here you'll see three options: Find a Book, My Collections, and Shared Collections. Let's start by creating a collection on dinosaurs, and then we'll show you how to share it. Click on Find a Book. Here you can use this filter to search by book band, reading level, lexile level, reading age, and more. We are going to select year level. Then you can adjust the filter over here. I'm looking for books appropriate for my year 2 class. You can also use this filter to search by topic. We're simply going to use the search bar. To create a new collection, click the plus symbol and select Create New Collection. Alternatively, you could also add this book to an existing collection. I already have a collection on dinosaurs started, so I'm going to add this book to my dinosaur book box. While we're here, you can also select the heart icon to add a book to your favorites. Your favorites will appear with the rest of your collections back over here under My Collections. Here are my favorites, and over here is my dinosaur collection. Collections are great for class discussions around favorite books, topic work, book clubs, and guided reading. They're also a great alternative to assigning books as homework. Unlike assigned books where the student needs to read and complete the quiz, a shared collection lets the students browse and preview the books before choosing one. Giving them choice helps establish a habit of reading for fun. Okay, now let's share our dinosaur collection. Collections can be shared with the entire class, groups of students, or individual students. You could even share just part of the collection. Since my class is doing a research project on dinosaurs next week, I'm going to select the whole class. Since we aren't starting until next week, I'm going to schedule this to be shared a week from now, and I'm going to give my students 2 weeks with this collection before we move on to our next topic. Okay, now I've shared this with my class. In 1 week, it'll appear to them on the librarian's desk in the student library. If I go back to the top and select Shared Collections, I can see the collections I'm currently sharing. I can also see any collections that have been shared to my students by the subscription coordinator at my school, or teachers I share classes with. In the next tab, I can see previously shared collections, or if I click My Students, I can see the collections shared with each individual student. If I need to make a change to a current collection, I can do so here by clicking Edit Sharing. Each of these areas can be exported to a CSV, making it easier to share lists with my fellow teachers, or I could just share the entire collection with them. If you're the subscription coordinator at your school, you can create and assign collections with the whole school or with specific classes and students. You can also see what book collections have been assigned to any student in the school in the All Students tab of Shared Collections. Okay, now I'm going to quickly show you one more new feature you might not have seen yet. When you're searching for books, there's a new handy Resources tab so you can easily find books with additional resources. You can either preview the book in the library or use these tabs to review the book details, read a description, or click resources to download the book in a variety of printable formats. And that's it! You've learned how to create and share book collections with your students and other teachers at your school. Bye for now!